Today's Microsoft tip will work across a variety of versions of Microsoft Excel. And this tip is on calculating total seconds in Excel, which was inspired by a colleague of mine who asked, "How do I calculate total seconds?" And what he meant by that was, instead of displaying a timestamp in the hours, minutes, second format, he wanted to instead display the time as total seconds, or what we call elapsed seconds. So his initial question of how do I calculate total seconds really wasn't about calculating. It was instead about formatting. And what he meant to say was, how do I format time as elapsed seconds? Which brings us to a confusing point about Excel for most users. There is a big difference between content, or how data is stored, and formatting, or how data is displayed in Excel. In other words, what you see is not always what you get. This is especially true when it comes to date time information. And I'm not going to get into the full explanation just now, but if you'd like to learn more about this topic, Danny Rocks Excel, another YouTube video guy, has a very detailed clip on this very topic you should check out later. But for now, just know that the bottom line is this: the combination of what you type and how you format your cells determines how data is displayed in Excel. Now, let's look at some examples. So here I've zoomed into a very small, very simple spreadsheet, and I have two columns. I have one column that I want to display the timestamp in the hours, minutes, seconds format. So I'm going to enter a simple timestamp right now. I'm going to enter 0:02:25. Now notice when I pressed enter what it did to the time. Moved it over to the right-hand side of the cell, and it looks like it should. Now, when I go back and select the cell, I want to draw your attention to the number format. On the Home tab in the number group, this little drop-down box now says Custom. Before, it said General. And if I click on this little button in the lower right-hand corner, that'll open up my Format Cells Number dialog box and will give me a little bit more information about the formatting that Excel has automatically applied to this cell based on the information I typed into it. Now, I type the lead 0, the colon, the 02, the colon, the 25, and Excel goes, oh, you must be typing in hours, minutes, and seconds. And it applied this formatting to that cell automatically. Now, watch what happens. I'm just going to go ahead and click OK and move down to the cell below. Now, I'm going to type something different. This time, I'm not going to type that lead 0. I'm just going to type the number 2, colon, and 25. When I press Enter, well, it looks the same, except it doesn't have those lead zeros. When I select the cell, still says Custom up at the top, but when I click on that button to launch the Format Cells dialog box, notice the custom formatting that it has applied. It hasn't applied it as hours, minutes, seconds. It's applied it as simply hours and minutes. Where the 2, where I wanted to type 2 minutes and 25 seconds, Excel thinks I meant to type 2 hours and 25 minutes. Now I could go back and apply the formatting that I want, but notice what happens to the information. When I click OK, Excel didn't read that initial typing that I did of entering that data in as minutes and seconds. It read it, interpreted it as hours and minutes, which is a big problem for my spreadsheet if I really did mean 2 minutes and 25 seconds. So that's kind of what I mean by what you type is very important. And if you want Excel to recognize hours, minutes, and seconds, or minutes and seconds, you need to type that lead 0. Now let me go over here to the timestamp seconds thing, and I'm going to do the exact same thing. I'm going to type 0:02:25, and I'm going to press enter. It does the exact same thing, but now this time I'm going to change the formatting. I want to display 2 minutes and 25 seconds as total seconds, or elapsed seconds. So for that, I'm going to need to customize my number format. So going up to that format dialog box, or I can press the keyboard shortcut Control-1, and that will bring that format cells dialog box up right away. What I'm going to do is type my own custom format. And to get the elapsed seconds, or elapsed anything, elapsed hours, elapsed minutes, what you do is surround the formatting with brackets, square brackets. So if I want to show just the seconds elapsed, I need to type open square bracket, S, close square bracket. And it should show you a sample of what that looks like above, your data actually typed into that cell and what the result is going to be. And now when I click OK, now I am displaying that data, that 2 minutes and 25 seconds, as just seconds or elapsed seconds.